So masks are optional, but people are just wearing them? Is that
it's not optional.
Not optional?
Mm-hmm. Because it's like numbers are going up.
Yeah.
Barbara was telling me she was on a meeting with executive directors from all around the country, and like in some places it's getting really bad. I mean, nobody's dying or anything. They're just everybody's getting COVID, right?
Yeah.
Did you just turn? Oh, they're on, but they're not.
They're on. There is a motion. You have to be able to drag the screen, and it's not allowing him to. It's a stopping.
So then, why don't we just turn off the TVs?
Well, he's calling Mary to see what he's missing.
She's on vacation.
Isn't she away?
Yeah, she's on vacation, but maybe she'll answer.
The problem is that anyone online is not going to see.
Yeah, but we don't. The only thing we're only putting up very few things now, like names.
Right.
So why don't we do this? This is off.
You think the gallops are like candles?
Say what?
You think the gallops are like candles?
The mourners, do you want me to put them like that on the spot?
No, I'll ask, but you don't have to like pass Shiva, you can do things.
You want me to ask them?
You can, yeah, sure. Thank you.
118 for the past couple of weeks. It is in the prayer book on page 273 on the bottom. We hope that you'll join us in song. Min ha-meitzar karatiya, I call out to Adonai from my narrow places. Please answer me. I've been connecting with this prayer, especially now in these coming weeks as we begin to enter this Jewish mourning period leading up to Tisha B'Av. I feel like whatever your practices you might be commemorating and marking Tisha B'Av or not, but I find like it's always a nice reminder to bring us in to this reflective mood. Please, let's sing together on page 273. Min ha-meitzar, I've called out to Adonai. Min ha-meitzar. Let's try that again.
Shabbat Shalom. Welcome to Temple B'nai Or, to our people here, to our people out there. Let's say Shabbat Shalom to each other. Introduce yourselves to the people around you. Shabbat, if you're online, of course, say hi in the chat. I want to start our services, well, continue to start our services, with a thought from Rabbi Mordechai Kaplan, the great 20th century thinker and leader in American Judaism. It's from a book I got a little while ago, A Year with Mordechai Kaplan. It takes his thoughts and kind of has them, those thoughts reflect on the weekly Torah portion, and then the Rabbi Stephen Carr Rubin, who edited, writes the Devar Torah based on both. But in this week's Torah portion, Pinchas, we have the story of the daughters of Slofchad. I'll explain more about them later, but they're women who come to Moses to give an answer. They have the chutzpah to stand up and talk to Moses and demand an answer for their grievance. So here's this thought from Mordechai Kaplan. Good thought to start Shabbat and put us into next week. It is true that we are thrust into a world we did not make. But who makes the world in which our children are thrust? That really hit me. We think about climate change, think about problems with democracy, we think about et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Today, as we begin Shabbat, we know we can't change the world. We shouldn't try to change the world. We should just be in the world right now. But Sunday, what is this world we're creating for our children? I'll read it again. It is true that we are thrust into a world we did not make, But who makes the world into which our children are thrust? May that world be a world of light. Let us bring in Shabbat with light. It's our honor to call up Stephen and Deborah Golub to light our Shabbat candles. The blessing is on page 2. Page 24.
Shalom aleichem, malachei ha-shalom, malachei Elohim, mimech, malachei ha-malachim, ha-kadosh
Turn back to page 13, Shu'u L'Adonai, Shir Chadash, sing out to God a new song. Even though the words we sing are the same words, how do we make a new song out of the same words?
Shu'u L'Adonai, Shir Chadash, Shu'u L'Adonai, Kol Ha'aretz, Shu'u L'Adonai, Baruchu Shemo.
Chadodi is on page 20.
La 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 la, Chadodi. La 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 la.
Pray together on page 30. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher bidvaro ma'ariv aravim v'chokma poteach sha'arim v'dvuna mishane itim machalif et hazmanim msader et hakochavim b'mishmerotehem barakia kirtzono borei yom v'laila golel or mimne choshech v'choshech mimne or.
ומבדיל בין יום ובין לילה אדוני צבאות שמו El chai v'kayam Tamid imloch aleinu le'olam va'ed Baruch ata Adonai Ha'ma'ariv raviv
Amen. Page 32. Everlasting love you offered your people Israel by teaching us Torah and mitzvot, laws and precepts. Therefore, Adonai, our God, when we lie down, when we rise up, we will meditate on your laws and your commandments. We will rejoice in your Torah forever. Day and night, we will reflect on them, for they are our life, and doing them lengthens our days. Never remove your love from us. Praise to you, Adonai, who loves your people, Israel.
בכל לבבך ובכל נפשך ובכל מאודך והיו הדברים האלה אשר אנוכי מצווך היום על לבבך ושיננתם לבניך ודיברת בם בשבתך בביתך ובלכתך בדרך, ובשוכבך ובקומך, וקשרתם לאות על ידך, והיו לטוטפות בין עיניך, וכתבתם על מזוזות ביתך ובשעריך, למען תזכרו ועשיתם את כל מצוותיי, ויתם קדושים לאלוהיכם. אני אדוני אלוהיכם, אשר הוצאתי אתכם מארץ מצרים, להיות לכם לאלוהים. אני אדוני אלוהיכם.
אמת, page 38. All this we hold to be true, and trustworthy for us. You alone are our God, and we are Israel, your people. You are our sovereign and savior, who delivers us from oppressors' hands and saves us from tyrants' fists. You work wonder without number, marvels beyond count. You give us life and steady our footsteps. You perform miracles for us before Pharaoh, signs and wonders in the land of the Egyptians. You led your people Israel out from their midst to freedom for all time. When your children witnessed your dominance, they praised your name in gratitude. And they accepted your sovereignty. Moses, Miriam, and all Israel sang to you together, lifting their voices joyously.
We're going to sing this prayer, lifting our voices joyously, celebrating our freedom, as did Moses and Miriam at the sea. But since this week is the week of Parashat Pinchas, which I recall very clearly because that was the time that I had a sabbatical and I actually studied a lot of Torah in that time, and I immersed myself in that Torah portion, Pinchas. And I'm glad the rabbi chose to highlight the most important part of the Torah portion, the daughters of Tzlofchad, which is a very small, tiny episode. But since he's mentioned the tyrants and the tyranny that somehow still is afflicting us, I want us to think about this Torah portion, about this episode of Notzlofchad, and to think and to feel pride that in our roots, there's actually, although it was very, very tough for women in biblical times, but there's actually seeds of democracy and freedom for women in the Torah, and I hope we continue to fight for this freedom for all women everywhere. Now let's sing it.
Amen. Page 42.
We segue from joy to comfort and healing with the words of Hashkivenu that we sing differently every time, even though it's the same words. But we are different as we journey through life. Different moods, different things that happen in our lives that make us feel differently. And so this prayer, so beautifully written, asking for God to protect us from harm and to spread over us a sukkah shalom. Each time we say these words, we may gravitate towards a different part of that beautiful prayer. We sing together, Hashkivenu.
Hashkivenu.
Amen.
Together let's say, and more reminders from our prayer book to keep this day, to keep this very important concept of Shabbat. And we sing on page 44 our favorite tune, said no one. Veshamru bene Israel This is a section of prayers which we ask Adonai for various things. We take this prayer, usually it is our custom in the evening to say it to ourselves independently, privately. We're going to begin together asking God to open up our lips. And then we're going to continue each on our own. When you have completed the section on page 62, please be seated at that time. We begin together. Please rise if you are able. Take a beautiful big breath and exhale this week. And inhale the beauty and the quiet of Shabbat. Lev tahor, brali Elohim, veruach nachor. Chadesh bekirbi al tashlicheni milfanecha veruach kodshecha al tikach mimeni Adonai sfatai tiftach ufi yagid et emilatech Tehinatecha, Svatai tiftach, Ufi hagi, Tehinatecha.
We pray now for our loved ones who are in need of refuah shleima, in need of healing, refuah ha-nefesh, refuah ha-guf, a healing of body, a healing of spirit. Because of technical difficulties tonight, I don't have the names on the screens, but if you are praying for someone tonight and you'd like to say their name, please do so as I go around. If you're online, you can put names in the chat. In the chat, all the names were put there. Look at that. Larry, tonight we're praying for Larry Benson, Margot Blaustein, Lisa Bush, Claudia DeGisu, Nicholas DeGisu, Richard Feibel, Bruce Goldman, Eileen Goldstein, Harriet Goldstein, Lena Hammer, Oliver Horn, John Houston, Sheila Carner, Bernadette Kearns, Gay Clapman, Albert Kahn, Leon Kurland, Sherry Levis, Deborah Littman, Joseph Lupkin, Lori Mazzarella, Reese Osmond, Judy Ragona, Eileen Reinfleisch, Francis Rizik, Gail Rush, Buddy Scott, Bernice Side, Alan Silverstein, Gilbert Simon, Glenn Swatinski, Marjorie Van Dow, Allison Rosenvogel, Lisa Wolper, and Edie Weinstein. And added, we have Pat Moon and A.G. Reed Sr.
Kavod to Ben Harder in the back, who is being intuitively intelligent.
Yeah. Some of you know that for all rabbis, cantors, educators who are trained at Hebrew Union College, Jewish Institute of Religion, the Reform movements, seminary, they spend their first year in Jerusalem. And of course, I spent my first year in Jerusalem. And I remember this one time that still implanted in my memory, that part of the curriculum, we would go once a week and have tiulim, field trips around the country to learn about Israeli society. And once we went to what's called a secular high school. And we sat in on a class, and that class at the secular high school was a Judaism class. And in this Judaism class in the secular high school, they were studying that day Avot, a section of the Mishnah where our sages give sage advice. Our sages give a lot of maxims, ethical sayings of how to live. What they were studying that day was the first section. It goes this way. Moses received the Torah from Sinai and transmitted it to Joshua. Joshua to the elders to the prophets, and the prophets handed it down to the men of the great assembly. This is what we call the train of tradition, the authority of the Torah and how to interpret the Torah passed down from one generation of leaders to the next. One student in this class was reading this out loud for the rest of the class, and they were going to discuss it. So the teacher then asked the students, who did the men of the great assembly, Anshei HaKnesset HaGadolah, Anshei Knesset HaGadolah, who did they transmit the Torah to? That was the last in the chain. And that student, a young girl, 15, 16, she said, to us. And the reason I remember this time in this class is here was a secular student, a girl, no less, enthusiastically putting herself in the chain of Jewish tradition. She was grabbing hold of the Torah. She was saying, I have the authority to read and interpret the texts. She was a part of this interpretive tradition. That is our tradition, an interpretive tradition. I bring this up because it's connected to this week's Torah portion. First, because it's one of the times in the Torah where it talks about Moses handing the authority over to Yehoshua, to Joshua. But also, as I mentioned at the beginning, in the cantor reiterated, this week's Torah portion has Bnot Slofchad, the daughters of a man named Slofchad. Let me give you the backstory about them. They're mentioned twice in the Torah this week and next week, in a few weeks, they come back. So Slofchad was a man. He dies. In the Torah, sons inherit property. They're about to enter into the land of Israel, where all of the families are going to get property in the land of Israel. Slofchad has no sons. It seems maybe the daughters are not married yet into other families. So they say, they go to Moses and say, can we inherit, or not inherit, can we establish some property in the land of Israel? Now, they say also that their dad has died. Why has he died? They said he died of his sins. But, they say, he was not of the men of Korach, which we read a few weeks ago. Korach led a rebellion against Moses. So the Meshech Chokmah, a 19th century commentary, written by Simcha of Dvinsk, he said, why'd they mention that their dad was not a member of Korach? He's dead, he's dead. I'm interpreting here. He's dead, he's dead. What does it matter? Well, in the Talmud, it says that the daughters were wise, which to the rabbis of the Talmud means they knew Jewish law. They were wise, and they knew that if, in traditional Jewish law, if you get executed, your family, your sons still inherit your property, except, and I don't need to get into the details, except if they're rebelling against the king, which it seems like Korach were doing, rebellion against Moses, then the king inherits the property. Okay. So they're pointing out to Moses, I'm getting a little technical here, but it'll make sense in a minute. They're pointing out to Moses, first, they're saying, we're part of this interpretive tradition. Our dad, yes, he didn't do great things, but we should inherit, or we should get land. We are part of this chain of tradition. But notice, they had to make themselves part of that chain of tradition by understanding. It is a important moment in our Torah for us to take values of what we would call today democracy, egalitarianism, and read other texts through that. But I think we can also read through that text an idea that I've been talking about for the last few weeks during sermons, of authority and autonomy. They stood up, had the chutzpah to stand up and say, we can interpret. We're not Joshua, we're not judges, we're not sages, but we can. So can you. So, how does this work? We, modern liberal Jews, have to take that authority. It takes education, it takes humility, it takes time, and it takes guidance. That's hopefully our job. But ultimately, I don't have the same authority that a rabbi 200, 300 years ago would have, where I can give you an answer, because you know what? You can quit the shul and go somewhere else, or don't do that, or you can just say no. Nobody's going to stop you from living your Jewish or life otherwise, right? So what is this authority that I have, and what is the authority that you have? I have a persuasive authority, hopefully, with humility, with grace, with hopefully decent teaching skills. I can help equip you. But what's your job? Your job is to continue the study too and to place yourself into this train of tradition, just like our girl in the classroom in Jerusalem did. Actually, it was in Tel Aviv, I think, did. Eugene Borowitz writes, if Jews could confront their Judaism as Jewish selves and not as autonomous persons in general, meaning, yes, you have the freedom to do whatever you want, not whatever you want, but you have a freedom to walk away, not engage in Judaism, not engage in our texts, not engage in our traditions. But something is calling you to do that. So you do engage in the world as Jewish selves. Borowitz writes, I contend that they would find Jewish law and the lore the single best source of guidance as to how they ought to live. Rooted in Israel's corporate faithfulness to God, they would want their lives substantially structured by their people's understandings of how its past, present, and future should shape their daily existence. So to be, as he called, an autonomous Jewish self is to hold this autonomy and this boundedness in tension all the time. You're confronted with an ethical issue. How do we stand up as the Jewish self? You're looking at a text. How do you have the tradition sitting on one shoulder and your own ways of feeling and interpreting on the other shoulder? That's what it means to be a liberal Jew. We're inspired by the Daughters of Slovchad. We're inspired by the girl I met in Israel to say, I'm part of this tradition, and I can take part in this tradition. It's not easy to live this life. It's hard to be a Jew. But when I say that phrase, it's hard to be a Jew, meaning to thoughtfully be a Jew, to consciously be a Jew, to be part of this chain of tradition. Moses received the Torah from Sinai and transmitted it to Joshua, and Joshua to the elders, and the elders to the prophets, and the prophets handed it down to the great assembly, and here we have it in our hands. Shabbat Shalom. So let's stand like we're standing at Sinai. If you're in the ways that you can, pay page 282.
בהחלדון הכל לתת גדולה להיות סהר בראשי שלא עשנו כגויי הארצות ולא הוסמנו כמשפחות האדמה שלא שם חלקנו כהם וגור עלינו ככל המונות ואנחנו קוראים משחבים ומודים לפני מלך מלכי המלכים הקדוש ברוך
285. Think of our loved ones whom death has recently taken from us, those who died at this season in years past, those whom we have drawn into our hearts with our own. If you're here to say Kaddish for a loved one, please feel free to rise when I say their name so that we can give honor to their memory, give honor or support to you. Sad to announce the recent death of Jerry Hodges, the father of our congregant Rick Hahn. And we are in the period of Shloshim, the first month of mourning for Wendy Pass, Fred Golub, Lisi Noss, and Edward Schwartz. This week marks the yard site, the anniversary of the death of Levi Breslerman, Isidore Cohen, Ada Dannenberg, Molly Dworetsky, Ruth Feilenbaum, Benjamin Firstman, Lee Gewertz, Eva Goldman, Nathan S. Haberman, Molly Iskowitz, Selwyn Leeds, Sarah Litwin, Irving Milstein, Ruth Meider, Betty Pardo, Brenda Pliskin, Catherine Podolsky, Samuel L. Riskin, Hannah Rubel, Yitzhak Rubel, Anita Saltzman, Alfred Spur, Irving Tepperberg, Sarah Wachtel, Albert M. Weiss, Daniel Weitz, Joseph White, Gertrude Wolper, and Sonia Tepperman-Zurwarski. If you're remembering someone tonight whose name was not mentioned, you like to say their name, please do so. If you're online, you can add names to the chat. Zichronam livracha, may their memories be for blessing. The mourner's Kaddish is on page 294. Please rise. Yitkadal v'yitkadash shmei Rabbah, v'yalmad divrach hirutei, v'yamlich malchutei, v'chayechon uv'yomechon, uv'chaye d'cho beit Yisrael, ba'agala uv'izman kariv v'imru, amen. Yehei shmei Rabbah mevorach,
Le'olam u'amei amaya. Yitbarach, yishtabach, yitpa'ar, yitromam, yitnasei, yithadar, yitalev, yithalal, shemed kudusha, brichu. Le'elam in kober hata v'shirata, tushbach hata v'nechamata, dami ran bi'alma v'imru, amen. Yehesh lama rabba min shamaya, v'chayim aleinu v'al kol Yisrael, v'imru, amen. Ose shalom bimromav, hu yase shalom aleinu v'al kol Yisrael, v'imru, amen. May the one who creates harmony on high bring peace to us, to all Israel, to all of the world, to which we say, amen. After Kiddush and Motzi, please join us probably in the courtyard. We'll have a nice, warm oneg together in the courtyard, and please spread the word. Join us all summer for Temple B'nai Or.
This is my last one for the summer, because I'm off to Israel, so l'chaim, and sang tefillat haderech for me, okay. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam borei pri hagafen. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kidushanu b'mitzvoto v'ratzonu v'shabbat kodesho v'ahava u'ratzon hinchilanu zikaron le'maaseh v'reishit ki hu yom techila למקראי קודש זכר ליציאת מצרים Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam hamotzi lechem min haaretz Shabbat shalom.
No Ami tonight?
No, they got home from camp, very tired.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Have a good fun. See you soon again. Thank you.